Whether you're working with clients who want final say on posts before they go live, or you're maintaining consistency within a wider team, approval workflows help you reduce errors and keep the quality of your social media content high. There are three different ways to use approval workflows. The first is through the Compose box, where you can keep the ability to post live, but also send for approval to any users that you have access to. The second is to send messages for approval in bulk using the bulk importer. However, keep in mind that the approver will need to approve the messages one by one. Finally, you can restrict a user so that they can only send messages for approval, never live. Admins can set up restricted approval workflows either when they create a new user or when they edit an existing one. Navigate to Workflow and toggle Yes. This removes the option for this user to send now when composing messages. While you can only designate one person to receive posts for approval, there is an option for a multi-level approval workflow that I will show you later in this video. Now, I'm going to switch into the dashboard of the user who needs approval. When I compose a message as this user, you can see I'm only given the option to send for approval. When you send a post for approval, the user you send it to will get an email and an in-app notification of the task. If I customize each post, then there will be two approval notifications, one for each platform. If I don't customize the posts, then only one notification bundling the two social media platforms will be sent to the approver. You can schedule when a post should go out or if it should be added to a queue. If a post isn't approved before the scheduled date, it will automatically go out as soon as the user approves it. Before the post gets sent, I have the option to add a note. Now I'm going to log into the dashboard of the approver and head to My Tasks. This is how a notification looks if you don't customize posts per platform, and this is how a split notification looks. You can choose to comment, approve, or reject. If you select reject, you have the option to add a note explaining why. Here's where multi-level approvals come in. Once I've made my edits, I can now send this post to another user that I have access to. If the post looks good, then I can just click approve and send. If you're on the move, you can also approve and reject posts via the email notification. Now it's time to make sure your social media content stays on brand and your copy is free from typos by using approval workflows. Happy sending!